The Griswold family Christmas tree.
Isn't it a little big?
That's what she said.
Whoa.
Very special episode of Quit Stalling, Quitsmas Edition, is brought to you by Drinks.com. Use the promo code QUITSTALLING_366 at checkout to get 10% off of your geek gear, your holiday geek gear, StarCraft shirts, Warcraft shirts, Hearthstone shirts. Use the promo code QUITSTALLING_366 again to 10% off at checkout. Use the promo code QUITSTALLING_366. Skype banter. I don't know if people can hear me right now, but welcome everyone to Quit Stalling. Oh, I don't know. Can you guys hear me? Hello.
We can hear you just fine. We can't see you.
We don't want to get into your intro, man. So.
Oh, okay. Shoot. Hold on. Let me share my screen. I think I turned it off when James came on.
All right, there we go.
Yeah, you should see me now. You should see me now. Hello, everyone. Oh, whoops.
There we go.
Stop doing that.
Gotta stop doing this. Yeah. Gotta stop this. All right.
Oh, this is so cool.
Yeah, I know, right? There's so many of us today on this special Quitsmas edition of the Quit Stalling Talk Show. All right. I got lost with all this hubbub. What was I gonna do? Okay. Welcome everyone to the very special to one of our very special episodes of Quit Stalling. This is Quitsmas episode B. Where we kind of freestyle it, you know, freestyling. When I rap, I lose confidence. With me today, like he is on most of my shows, the man with more podcasting and radio experience than all the Quit Stalling Talk Show hosts combined, Mr. Gallard Labarez. Gallard, how you doing, man?
Doing great. What's up?
Oh, what happened?
What's up, Gallard Nation?
Oh, we're still doing that?
Yeah.
I don't want to do that.
No, seriously, what's up? Hey, what's up? What's up?
Alright, and now technically the longest running co-host on the Quit Stalling podcast, Mr. Jay Sanchez himself, the aggro crag of geeks.
Hey, what's up?
How you doing? How you doing, Home Slice?
How you doing?
I'm doing pretty good. How you doing?
All right. Running very far behind him as the second longest running co-host on Quit Stalling, James Gutierrez, live from sunny South America. dropping
what
bombs.
What an introduction. Thank you.
Dropping beats and bombs, James.
Hola, buenos dias, buenas tardes, buenas noches for depending on what time zone we're in. Why are you looking at me? Like, I only see Jay's face because everything else is kind of frozen for me, but Jay's face.
No gang signs. Only Jay's I'm not moving. Signs, James.
There. Only signs. Jay's face is moving, but I'm. It's my hand. Just because my hat's backwards doesn't make everything I do a gang sign.
Said the man from Portland.
That's some profiling right there, Jay.
Oh, my God. It's like Gallard doesn't know what he walked into.
No, Gallard hasn't been on a show with both of us yet. This is going to be fun.
He has not. This is going to be good. It's going to be really good. All right.
Touching the light.
Plus, Sam's in the mix now, so it's going to be crazy.
With us today, writer extraordinaire for the Quit Stalling US website, Santiago Santa Cruz. How you doing, San?
I'm good. Merry Christmas. Happy Woo! Hanukkah. Merry Krampus. All that good stuff.
Shalom and nanu nanu to you, Festivus. San.
Happy Festivus.
Hold on, sorry.
Oh, happy Festivus. Happy Festivus.
There we go. We're good. I can hear you guys again.
All right. Sweet, sweet. It's good to see you, San. San will be joining us regularly from here on out, and it's a pleasure to have him. It's a pleasure to have him. And for the first time,
one of us.
Sorry. Very early on in the Quit Stalling chronology, we have five hosts on. We usually try and prevent this from happening because it's a mess, but since it's Quitsmas, it's gotta happen. It's gotta happen. We got lights and everything.
We also try to not. We also try to make sure this doesn't happen, because otherwise we form Voltron, and that's never good for everyone around us.
What happens when we have to save the Earth, guys? Come on.
Well,
and,
you know,
Harold just missed.
I'm in the middle. Am I the head?
We're gonna die. The other head.
We're fucked, man.
It's over. We are screwed. So I mean, Gallard, you know, as a leg to stand on, isn't so bad.
Yeah, totally. I have no problem being an appendage. I'm already close.
That's such a weird statement.
I'm the one bad knee.
You're the bad knee.
I am the one that creaks when you squat. That's my superhero tagline.
So as you folks can tell, as you folks at home can tell, no actual format for these Quitsmas shows. You know, this is a free for all. We're just gonna talk because we're gonna let loose for once. We usually have such a strict format imposed on us by that tyrant of a founder here on Quit Stalling. So now we're just gonna cut loose, make fun of James's beanie and bicycle and boobs, and you know, just keep going. And his anime eyes.
Why am I the target? Like, I just got
anime,
on.
Anime eyes Gutierrez. Calm down, man.
I'm calm. I'm totally calm.
See, the A and the E in James actually stands for anime eyes.
What does the rest of the name stand for?
Doesn't matter, man.
Oh, okay. Okay. Think. Because the A and the E are nowhere near each other. Go, do it. Make it.
I think we're fine as Voltron if James is the head, because at least we got anime eyes.
Fitting.
Oh, God. Oh, real quick, I want to point out that I am fresh off the rack today. As you can see, I am a size small, and things are going good.
Do you plan to return that? Is that why the tag is?
Something with a tag?
After the show, I will be returning the shirt and complaining. thank you for pointing that out, Santa. You've trying to be frugal. Thank you. Yes.
Yeah, no problem.
Thrift shop. Hip stop walking. All right. So we don't really have anything to talk about in specific. So I just want to throw it out there. How has the season been for you guys so far? As of recording this, we just got into the holiday seasons.
I'll start.
Yeah, please.
I was waiting. I was gonna let someone go, but thank you.
Okay. Oh, it's been good, man. It's been doing some writing, some freelance writing, writing for the Quit Stalling website. So if anyone's listening and bored, go ahead and check out those articles. They are good, and we try to get out as many as we can in a week. And we got some new writers, right? So that's always a plus. Yes, sir. Other than that, been doing some holiday shopping. Got my girlfriend a gift. I'm not going to say it on the show just in case she's watching or plans to at some point. But that was really close. I actually almost said it.
Is she going to listen to the show?
That, Yeah, probably. If she loves me, she better. So we'll see. Yeah, that's a test of love. You hear that? If you're listening right now, you know who you are.
Oh, snaps.
Yeah.
No, she's listening right now, though, then she passed it.
True. That's true. but yeah, I've been going back to the States for actual Christmas. Other than that, just going to be keep moving along. Holiday season, baby. Woo!
Sweet, sweet. Nice. All right. James, what how's the season been over there in South America?
Well, South America, it's been getting warmer since it's on the flip. We're on a reverse over here, so it's summertime. And it's getting pretty hot here in Peru, but it's fun. I'm coming towards the end of my project out here, so I am very, very much looking forward to coming back to Manila. But I won't be back until the 20th. So I'm going to miss the Christmas party. I'm coming back next week, at like a week and a half from now. But I'm very excited. It's been...
James is going to miss the Christmas party that we're throwing for everyone. It's going to be good. It's gonna be good. The aim is, actually, now that you bring it up, the aim is by 2017, we can rent out like a movie theater and have a Christmas party for our fans as well, all five of them.
Sounds so good.
All right. Yay! For the, you know...
What are we gonna for get? Us, for the five of us.
For the Janie
Max. Is that like the small theater in Greenfield 1? The small in theater in Greenfield 1 that has... That they do plays in?
It's so old.
Where we start.
You gotta start somewhere, right? You gotta start somewhere.
Yeah, don't... At least Ayala. You know?
Oh,
good choice.
Sponsored by James Gutierrez himself. All right, Gallard, what have you been up to this holiday season?
Well, as you can see, I'm still waiting for Christmas to kick in so I can have a new batch of shirts.
Ah.
I plan to wear this for the next four episodes. Just kidding. No, but oh yeah, it's been nice. It's been chill. You know, it's wonderful just being at home, relaxing, and shedding the occasional tear of joy every now and then. But It's all good.
See, the people who are listening to the podcast don't know this, but the people who are watching the videos, man, all our best jokes are happening when the cameras go down. It's such a.
Dude, this sounds so bad.
James, you know what happens when the cameras go down. Jay, man, how has the holiday season been treating you?
There's a bit of pressure because you know, like me and James, we love football, and now is the playoffs for fantasy football, and it is insane.
Oh,
you clinched a playoff spot, man. Stop.
Yeah, so it's crazier for James because he's trying to make the playoffs, but it's still pretty hard.
I'm a solid fourth, man. I'm gonna get it. I'm a solid fourth, and I'm a shoo-in for this next round.
How deep is your league?
12 team.
12. I'm in a 16 right now.
Ooh. Wait, 1-6 or 6?
Yeah, 1-6.
Oh, 16. That's so hard. That's so deep.
Yeah. I almost had a first-round playoff bye, but I lost my last matchup by 0.5. So I have to not play. So I have to play in the wild card round now.
Good luck.
I'm trying to imagine Gallard's face right now.
I hope you
right
win
now.
I win, man.
How many make it to the playoffs in your league?
There's 8 in the winner's bracket, 8 in the loser's bracket.
Okay.
Yeah.
Ted's is not setting up our league. Like he just picked the laziest option to do it, and the rest of us are too lazy.
I can imagine Gallard, man. He's just like, sports ball.
Sports ball.
Sports ball.
Not throw any shit at anyone, but it's really hard for me to grasp attaching the word fantasy to football.
We'll explain it to you one of these days.
I will clip out the audio that you say. D&D. It's really hard for me to grasp.
Yeah. Basically D&D for jocks, kind of.
Are you jocks?
Kind of.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. They're that hybrid of a jock nerd, so that they could play
that's
fantasy.
That's the best kind.
Yeah.
The best kind of nerd.
Yeah,
I'm
that's the kind of nerd.
That's
the kind of jock that doesn't get jock itch. So,
Gallard, if people are talking sports, here's what you say. Do you see that ludicrous display last night? And then there, they'll be like, yeah. Arsenal always walks it in.
Okay, that I get. I get that.
I'm just saying.
Okay, yeah, so I hope you guys have good luck in your fantasy playoffs with your fantasy football team.
Just for me and Sam, please. Not James.
Yeah, I'm rooting for James. I'm rooting for James, James. Among the Luyang Meerkats.
I'm actually the Marshawn Manhunters this year.
Oh, that is so good! I remember that! You sent me the logo!
Marshawn Manhunter.
That is so good!
That's a really good one.
Thanks.
James, what is your team's name? While we're on the subject.
James's team.
Mine is the Space Nazis.
Space Nazi.
Sad, what is your team's name?
Let's not talk about Nazis during Hanukkah. Year, my team's... I try to do, like, whatever... Try to base it around whomever's on my team. Mm-hmm. So last year, and the 2 years... 2 years ago and last year, my team was the Drinking Fortes.
I like it.
So we were Drinking Fortes, and I couldn't really come up with anything that hasn't already been done in our league this year, so I'm just Jeff Fisher's mustache.
Not Andy Reid's.
No, because I'm a big Rams fan. My family is a huge Rams fan, so I was like, well, Jeff Fisher does have a pretty sweet mustache, although I hate the guy right now, so.
Yeah.
And but that's nothing to do. His mustache didn't do anything. Oh, you know, that's nothing to do with his mustache.
Gallard, there's another layer for fantasy football. Like, there is a whole other game just to come up with the best team name.
It is.
Yeah, it's not an official game, but it's just
Dude, that sounds like something that should be awarded. You know,
Popular vote. It kind of is. In my league, for example. There are 16 people, right? And we all throw in like $50. And I forget how it's divided because I think there's compensatory prizes and everything. But if you have the best name and you win the league, you know, you get this plaque with your team name on it in the year. So like you have a ridiculous ass name.
So it's like the Shiva.
Exactly like the Shiva. It is.
Child except, please.
Did you just child please me?
No, I don't please Harold.
Child, please.
Child, please.
I'm not gonna child please you, San. I like your team
name.
Harold, do you play?
Jeff Fisher's mustache.
I used to play fantasy soccer and fantasy basketball, but I was an early adopter before anyone else started picking up fantasy sports, and I got burned out. Because you have to do you have to check your lineups every week, and doing that as a kid, in grade school, in seventh grade and first year high school, you know, it wasn't ideal, especially playing against adults. So I stopped.
What if Will Ferrell's esports movie is just fantasy football? Right?
Can you do fantasy esports?
God.
Yeah.
There is
you pick the. I have a friend who does it. You pick the team, and it's all about the wins. Just the wins. And kills.
Ah, yes.
I think there is for LOL.
I don't know what my fantasy esports team would be. I don't know what my name would be.
That's a good question. Depends on what game they're playing. What are they playing, Dota? Oh, I can't think of anything.
Harold's gone. Harold!
Lost him. I'd be the Koreans. I'd just be the Koreans.
That's the Koreans.
Number one draft pick.
Number one draft pick. James Gutierrez picks the Koreans.
It's like
damn it.
That episode of Chappelle's Show with the racial draft.
Yes. Yes. Asians got Tiger Woods.
No, he got drafted by the Blacks.
Oh no, he was drafted by the Blacks, and he was full because he was black, like, and he lost.
I can finally say this. I can finally say this, for shizzle. Something like that. I don't remember. If it's the N-word, I'm not going to drop it on here, so don't worry about that.
You white people are so funny.
It ain't easy being brown, Gallard. It ain't easy being brown.
I know, right? We're like outnumbered here 80 to 20.
Yeah. Yeah. Or, what? You know, 3-2.
Your mouth is so long.
This is Trump's version of a podcast, man.
Make quit stalling white again.
Make quit stalling white again.
Oh, God.
It's a good world we live in right now. Good world we live in. You know how good the world we live in is. You know, we have things. What?
Boss end.
Harold, keep going.
I lost my train of thought.
I got it. Nice.
I'm taking off my small sticker.
It's a very good world we live in. Something, yeah, there.
All right. What was I saying? Oh, yeah, we live in a world with technology that allows us to do podcasts like this, you know? And just shoot the shit and have a steady listener base of three. You know, those guys are, you know, are the lifeblood of Quit Stalling.
I'm there. I watch.
Thank you.
I just got fake. You're welcome.
Sorry, Sam, what were you saying?
Gonna say for festivity just from now on for the rest of the episodes we're just gonna call them the Three Kings, you know, since it's good Christmas season.
Yes.
Oh, I thought you were talking about me, you and James.
Oh yeah, we can do that too. Yeah.
The white people assume the Three Kings
are us. Alright, so we're getting rid of them. Bye guys. Thank you for joining us on Quit Stalling.
Thank you, Harold.
Right, so Gallard, how you doing, man?
Hey, man, my favorite Jesus.
All right, let me bring them back. There's out of timeout.
There's Jesus, we see him in the background.
But it's not floating, he's floating on a cloud behind you.
Yeah, where's the holy hand grenade? Where's the holy hand grenade?
That's the thing you have.
Is he? What side is he in?
What if God is like, what are you talking about? There's nothing there.
Oh my God, and it's upside down.
I'd be like, oh, that's just not scary. Sorry, James, that's too much, man. That's scary.
Oh, that's... I might have to end the show quickly here, man. That's scary. That's some scary stuff.
Just close Gallagher's camera if that happens.
Don't let it spread, man. Don't let it spread.
Our cameras start going off one by one, right?
World War Z shit cut off the arm. Sorry, Gallard, you said you wanted to be an appendage. We're cutting it off.
We're cutting it off.
Okay.
Oh, gosh. The curse.
No, don't do that. Oh,
what's happening?
I don't know, man.
Gallard was replaced by sidearm.
Have you guys seen that movie? I think it's like Unfriend Me or Unfriended or something like that.
Yeah, it's Unfriended. It's kind of like this.
It's kind of like this, but then like people just started dying, like in the webcam.
Yeah, I do remember seeing trailers for that.
Just remember, James, it's always the pretty ones that go first. So cover your eyes.
No! Dude, no, you know, I honestly think that. It's like, it's always, and I'm going to say it.
He honestly thinks he's the prettiest one.
No. Let me finish. In horror movies, it's always the minority, usually the black, the Asian, or whoever, that dies first. And you know why?
It's going to get really racist. I think we should stop.
No. It's logical, because you think about it. They get the fuck out of there, because it doesn't matter
Just like I would agree with this, it doesn't matter why the fuck the walls are bleeding. You don't need to find out why the walls are bleeding. Just get the fuck out. Die. White people, oh my god, why are the walls bleeding? I gotta figure this out.
Well,
and then they just go deeper. They go deeper in. Or they take showers in the middle of the, like, in the camp, and they're just like, hello, is anybody there? All right, I'm gonna get naked and take a shower. Like, yeah. Come on! Or, like, it's creepy as fuck
already.
Example,
the entire plot of the Blair Witch Project, three white people go into the woods asking for trouble.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, most definitely. Yeah.
We Filipinos don't want trouble.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, you guys have seen Stranger Things, right? Will Byers' mom, you know, the lights start flicking around. Will Byers' mom starts looking around like, Will, is that you? Bitch, get out of there! You don't know who the fuck that is!
Christmas lights aren't plugged to anything? Fuck that!
Yeah, but you gotta understand, she was looking for her son, so she had a reason to, like, chase the lights.
The lights start flicking. I would stop looking for my son and I would start running.
Get the cops first, man. That's what I would do.
That girl is crazy, man. Fucking probably stealing shit from Costco.
Winona Ryder is still pretty hot, though. I'd have to give that.
I wouldn't say in that show up, though. Right? She looks crazy in that show though.
Yeah. She's supposed to be
right.
Yeah, true. She's supposed.
That's Jay's thing, dude. That's Jay's thing.
No, the internet. That's not true. That's not true.
Oh, you're man. Like crazy.
I plead the fifth.
Oh man. So yeah, we'll buy his mom. So guys, one thing I did want to bring up on this show since we're talking about you know, just random stuff. What do you guys think of the Star Wars Disneyland Park edition?
Well, they already have a Star Wars ride. That's Star Tours.
Yeah,
right?
That's right.
Mm, yeah.
So Star Tours is fun. Like it's kind of random. Like you don't know which version of the ride you're gonna get because mm-hmm. there are different planets that you go to. But there's always one, like Rebel Spy. Right.
Okay.
So there was I rode it twice. The second time I rode it from the entrance up to the ride. I was just doing that. And the funny thing is, when they announced, they were like, there's a Rebel Spy in your ship. The screen focuses on the Rebel Spy, right?
Yeah.
It's me doing that. So, yeah, if there's more of that, then, yeah, that would be fun. I'm all for it.
Yeah. I mean, San wrote an article about it, and, you know, we got to see some concept art, and it looks good, man. If it's going to look anything like the concept art, it looks... You know, it's about time we got a Star Wars theme park.
Oh, for sure.
I think for the premiere of Rebel One, they're going to turn Epcot into the Death Star.
That'd be
so
that'd
for
be
Rogue One this month? For Rogue One?
Yeah, or maybe Star Wars Celebration next year, I'm not sure.
Oh, sweet.
But they are turning it into the Death Star for a bit.
That's awesome.
That's massive. Mm-hmm. That's massive. James, what are your thoughts on Star Wars Land?
This is something that, first of all, I want to say, Jay, don't do the Spock in Star Wars Land, man. That's not cool. Fucking Trekkies.
It's an actual gun sign over there.
They prefer Trekker. They prefer Trekker.
Number one.
Slap.
Get the Trekker out of here. No, I'm just playing. But it's always been a dream of mine to go to like something that is just completely immersible in a fantasy that I have put so much time and like as I guess it's a little it comes a little bit hard to say just because I've seen so many videos of the Disneyland what's it called? I'm lost for words here. The
emotional impact of Star Wars Land on James is too great.
Yeah, no, Star Wars Star Wars is really big in my life. Like, I'm getting a tattoo and just like later this month of the Mandalorian sign on my forearm. Like, Star Wars.
Are you also getting a tattoo of Ed Hardy on your arm?
It's gonna be designed by Ed
Hardy. God damn it!
Like a shirt.
Literally every shirt I'm gonna wear for the next couple episodes are all Star Wars related. So
nice.
not as tight and as this one.
A testament to how James is totally in love with the series. I remember one time one of our friends was wearing a Star Wars shirt, and along with Jay here, they tackled him down and took the shirt off and to keep for themselves.
It didn't help that friend weighed about 100 pounds soaking wet.
Yeah, Guanyu is a tree.
Guanyu is a stick, not a tree.
So that was one of the most eye-opening things I've ever seen on how far you can go in a fantasy. So, yeah.
In a fantasy?
The fandom is huge.
Different topic.
The fandom is huge.
Different topic altogether, but James is nuts. So I think that's what we can take away from that.
The one thing that makes me sad about Disney is that I think a month ago, they announced that they are closing the Twilight Zone Tower of Terror and they're replacing it with a Guardians of the Galaxy ride. Like that, I that's so sad.
Yeah,
that is a little sad.
I mean, how long has it been up there, right?
Yeah. I mean, there's no chance of a Rod Serling exposition now. It's probably just Rocket Raccoon just cursing and grabbing someone's robotic arm.
I am Groot.
I am Groot.
This is crazy.
I am Groot.
Alright, so, yeah, Star Wars Land aside, man, it's been a good year. And we're going to talk more about 2016 in just a little bit, or for those of you listening at home, in the next episode. So stay tuned for that. But before we go, let me turn down this bed music real quick. Before we go, and I'm gonna play us some more family-friendly music. Here we go.
Yay!
Here we go. All right. Before we go, Gallard, let's start with you. Where can the fine folks at home find you when you're not on the Quit Stalling Talk Show?
All right. You guys can find me over on Twitter at @GallardOwns, and also in the land of EOS right now. Sorry, Eorzea, you're out.
All right, Jay. Where can the fine folks at home find you when you're not on the Quick Song Talk Show?
If you're trying to look for me and if you want to hear about geeky stuff, you can find me on Twitter at JAnything89. That's where I'll be talking about stuff. Just spoiler warning. Chance for spoilers.
All right, James. Where can the folks at home find you when you're not on the Quick Song Talk Show?
Peru.
Well, when I'm not here. You can find me on Instagram. You're turning up the bed music, it's getting louder.
We
tried to drown me.
No, wait. The bed music is normal. We can't hear you.
Yeah, man.
It seems. Okay, there, can you hear me now?
There. You're good,
there.
You're good.
Yeah, there we go.
Okay.
All that head shaking was moving your mic around.
All right, you can find me on Instagram. That's rebel_scum1980. Check me out on Snapchat. That's Phil M Hero. Stop laughing. Where can you find folks? Find.
Okay. He's a bit hard to understand. So if you want to find him on Instagram, that's rebelscum.
Rebel_scum_rebel_
There's an underscore scum. 1980.
I gotta find a way to remove that underscore one of these days. In the middle of him saying it, I just want to mess with him. All right, James, I love you, man. I love you. Welcome back to the show.
We broke Gallard.
So while Gallard is throwing a fit, San, my man, where can the folks at home find you when you're not on the Quit Stalling Talk Show?
When I'm not on the Quit Stalling Talk Show, I am writing some nerdy, awesome articles for quitstalling.us, so you can look for some new articles there by moi, and you can follow me on Instagram at @IGaveAMooseAMuffin.
Awesome, awesome. Did you really give a moose a muffin?
I did. He came back for more.
Oh, yeah, never give animals food, because they'll always come back for more. If you want to find me outside of the Quitstong Talk Show, check out Game Bite. Game Bite's also going to have its own Quitsmas episodes, so stay tuned for those. If you want to find me on the social medias, YouTube, Twitch, Twitter, and Instagram, find Herald Plays, HERALDPLAYS. All you Harkonauts out there, please look for me.
God really is broken, man.
For more Quit Stalling, head on over to www.quitstalling.us or Quit Stalling Us. Find us on YouTube. Search for Quit Stalling. We're on SoundCloud, soundcloud.com/quitstalling. On social media, facebook.com/quitstallingus. Twitter, we're at quitstallingus. And of course on Instagram, @quitstalling. So please, please, please look for us. Leave us a 5-star review on iTunes because we deserve it. God knows we need 1 star for each person on the show right now. Thank you guys for listening to episode B of the Quitsmas specials on the Quitsong Talk Show. We're going to come back with more. Next episode will be about this year in comic books, so stay tuned for that. We'll see you guys next time. Bye, everybody. Bye.
Gallery, no gang signs.
This episode of Quit Stalling is brought to you by the Quit Stalling Podcast Studios Network. Find everything on www.quitstalling.us. Get off your butt and do something.